Today we are going to talk a topic which is called heart, and I took heart diseases and meta health. Now, often dil ki baat hai ye. That is how people will say ki, you know, you heard so many Hindi songs, and Hindi songs mein dil ke baare mein kitne tarike se bola jata hai. I have no other industry which talks and sings about the heart as beautifully as Bollywood does. In fact, every third song that is there in the Bollywood talks about love, talks about heart. And yet, we haven't registered that heart is the seat of love. And if so many people in my country today in India are not feeling okay and are having heart attacks, so kya hua? This is what we have to think. On one end, we are constantly talking about how heart, dil, is about love, and we just seem to be just talking about it. Kuch kar nahi rahe uske baare mein. Because if people, kafi baatein hoti hain, charcha hota hai, we become politicians. And we've become even better by sending quotes today on WhatsApp. So a little tale here. I went to US and I've just returned back last night for my daughter's graduation. And so she's a graduate, and so I've been graduated. So thank you. I graduated for the third time today. First my graduation, then my son's graduation, and now my daughter's graduation. Why am I bringing this when I'm talking about heart? When you bring up children, whether they are close to you physically, whether they are far away from you, it's because you have invested your heart in them. That you react when they are happy, you react as if you are happy. When they graduate, you feel you have graduated. When they move a mile, you feel you've really flown. Like I told you today when you walked in, ever since you become a grandparent, you look so happy. and not just that, you look younger, you look radiant, you look happy. Why is that happening? Why are you happy? You are happy because there's something that's...
Heart connections.
When we don't have the heart connections, is when we have heart attacks.
Yes.
In our country is the highest rate of heart attack. So kya hum sirf gaana gaate reh gaye? Reality mein ho sakta hai ki we chose our spouses not of our choices. We chose children not of our choices. We chose in-laws not of our choices. We chose a lot of professions not of our choices, and we were told that this is correct thing to do. I'm not coming in anybody's value system and beliefs. I'm talking plain science right now. And with science, if your heart is not attached to your job, not attached to your family, not attached to what you're doing, aap dil se nahi kar rahe hain, ya aap apne aap ko us jagah pe invest kar rahe hain jahan aapka dil hai hi nahi. ज़बरदस्ती कर रहे हैं तो आपके दिल पे असर होगा. वेरी सिंपली वी आर टुडे फोर्सिंग आवरसेल्व्स टू डू थिंग्स दैट वी डोंट रियली बिलीव इन. वेरी सिंपली वी आर प्रोबेबली गेटिंग मैरिड बिकॉज आवर फादर फील्स हैप्पियर इफ वी वुड गेट मैरिड टू दैट पर्सन, और आवर मदर वुड बी मोर अप्रूविंग ऑफ द पर्सनैलिटी हु वी आर गेटिंग मैरिड. And is there something wrong with that? There is nothing wrong with anything.
Yes.
Yet, as a child, when you are bringing up a little child, aap uske muh mein khana dal ke dekhiye jo uski pasand ka nahi hai, khayega kya? We have spent our entire life taming people to do things that they don't want to do. Could that be one of the reasons, other than our diet, other than our exercise, other than smoking, other than maybe having drugs, other than all the other things that we have put down together and said these are, this is what causes heart disease. Could it be our Soch that is creating our heart problem? So first let's look at the heart word and let's see how we can break it down. So let's pick up words. It's got
heart.
It's got
ear.
It's got ear. It's got tear. How many things, huh? Anything else you can see? Rat.
Rate.
Rate. Anything else?
He are.
Hate.
Here.
Here is put over here.
No. He are.
Heat.
Heat.
Heat, yes.
Very good. Anything else?
Ha.
There is no F here, but if I was to turn this and put other words with it. Fear.
Yes.
Fear. Tear is already there. Any other words that are coming to your mind? I've just given you a breakup. And why have I given you this breakup? Because no naming was done just like that. So what is it that the child hears with its ears for 9 months when it is inside the mother's womb? The child hears with its ears mother's heart. For 9 months, it's a tabla. You know what's a tabla? Tabla is an Indian instrument which goes dum 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 dum. It's a beat. Dum 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 dum. That heart is what they measure even with sonography, the dum dum, the dum dum, the dum dum of the baby inside. And can you imagine? It's so beautiful. I've said this before. Mother has the possibility having two hearts, not one, two hearts beating at the same time in her body during those 9 months. I mean, it's so beautiful. And that heart starts beating inside the baby when the baby is six weeks old. The brain of the baby is developed after that. The first sense, the first heartbeat is the brain beat, not the heartbeat.
Actually, heart is another brain.
Heart is the brain. And Heartmath Institute, I'll be using a lot of their work. Heartmath Institute has been doing research on various aspects of the heart. So let's look at each word. It's an art to hear what we hear. Because log kehte kuch hai, humko sunta kuch aur. Log kuch bhi kehte rahe, hame sunta wahi hai jo hum sunna
chahte hai.
Aur wo hamari soch ke saath connected hai. So we have to have even an art of hearing is called listening. Who are we listening to? Are we listening to our heart or are we listening to other people's hearts? And in our country especially, we have an epidemic. An epidemic of not living our own dream. We create dreams and then we want our children to live our dreams. our dream was not good enough to ruin our life. We couldn't accomplish it. Somewhere we have brought children into this world to take care of our dreams. I don't know how much money you will give them, how much property you will give them, and when you give them your property and money, now you will only give it to them when you die. But your weight of your dreams, you give them when you are alive. And it is so invisible, it is so sasta, it is so without money, that for you to give it, trade it down is so easy for you. I keep saying this, log apne sar ki jubi utha ke nahi dete nahi to. Yahan pe we give our dreams to our children, we don't ask them, do you want to live your life like this? Do you really believe what I'm telling you? Do you really see me successful? And there is nobody, not a single person that I know of, who has never spoken lies, who has never done anything that is ever wrong in their life. We somehow measure people on the yardstick of right and wrong. So we have very, how do we listen to things? Are they right or are they? This is the art that we have developed. Art of listening to what is right and what is wrong. And from those yardsticks, we think we are doing right things and we are doing wrong things. So having visited US and just come back after the graduation of my daughter and my third graduation, I realized that a lot of things that we think are wrong, they think are right.
Yes.
And that left me very confused. I've sent my daughter there, now her rights and her wrongs are different from my rights and my wrongs. So very easy for me to get hurt up. But I wanted her to get that education, right? That all my rights had become her wrongs and all my wrongs have become her rights. Have you ever faced that situation in your life when you were growing up, you suddenly found that what you wanted from your life was entirely different from how your parents were looking at things?
Yes.
Everybody does that. No, so you don't have to go to US to understand this. All I'm saying is you have to understand in your own space that tumne kaise suna kisi cheez ko. Maine suna ki ya to ye cheez sahi hai ya ye galat. Aur yahan se maine apne, I've taken my actions. And all my actions are impacting my heart, because all my actions are created by emotions. And those emotions are coming because I am perceiving things to be right or wrong. If I am not considering it as right and wrong, then somebody else is telling me, otherwise I wouldn't ask, na, mere baal theek lag rahe hain kya? I'm asking someone, meri dress theek lag rahi hai kya? I'm asking someone. Why am I asking their opinion? Because somewhere I have a doubt in my mind.
Yes.
And then when someone will say, no, it's really looking nice, then my doubt goes away. So, from here, if we look at the ear, and the part of the ear, you have to understand that our heart centers are right above our ear, in our brain. Okay? So if this is our brain, all of you, put your hand right. This is our brain. Very good. Then above your left ear, right ear, am I giving the right one? Yeah. Above the left ear is coronary veins. What is there?
Coronary.
Veins.
Artery.
Veins.
Veins.
The vein center is right above the left ear. Right above the right ear is coronary arteries. These centers are present in the brain. Clear? Let's do this once again. If this is my brain, above the left ear is coronary veins. Above the right ear is the coronary
artery.
Understood this much?
Yes.
And which part of the brain? There are four parts of the brain. So first part of the brain is called brainstem. Second part of the brain is called cerebellum. Third part of the brain is called medulla. Fourth part of the brain is called cortex. Let's repeat this again with me. You put your hand up like this. Very good. Brainstem.
Brainstem.
Cerebellum.
Cerebellum.
Medulla.
Medulla.
Cortex.
Cortex.
Simple. Let's do this once more. Brainstem.
Brainstem.
Cerebellum.
Cerebellum.
Medulla.
Medulla.
And cortex.
Cortex.
The part that I'm talking about is the
cortex.
Now cortex has got above the left ear, what is it got? Coronary
vein.
Very good. Above the right ear?
Artery.
Very good. So how will we remember it? We will give it abbreviation. CV. C. CV, that is coronary vein, is present on the left of the cortex. And coronary artery is present on the, again in the cortex, on the right side. Clear this much? No problem over here. So we picked up two main centers. Generally, if somebody has a heart attack, what do we say? There is a blockage. Where is that blockage?
In
coronary vein or in the coronary?
Normally artery.
Very good. Normally the
artery.
Clear? And where is that center present? In the brain. Above the left ear is coronary vein. Above the right ear is coronary artery. And these arteries and veins means what are they? Coronaries and arteries are like pipelines. These are pipelines which are carrying fluid. What fluid is, what fluid is it carrying? It's carrying
blood.
Correct? So something is happening inside that pipe where there is a blockage, which means the water is not able to, the blood is not able to pass properly. So imagine you have these pipelines, water pipelines throughout Mumbai. Somewhere there is a blockage. And because that blockage is there somewhere, that water is not able to reach your house. So the plumber comes, does the plumbing of that area, and all is jingala. This is what we do when we go for our heart cleaning.
Surgery.
What they do is, they can't open up your heart like this. So they endoscopically go inside. They see with the small camera that there is a blockage. And then they put a stent over there. And they open up your heart. After that, they make sure that your blood remains thin. Which means they give you two medications, which is Ecosporin or Copigril or a combination of these two, so that your blood remains thin forever. This is how they try preventing the blockage to happen again. Have you understood this much?
Yes.
So now we have looked at coronary veins, coronary artery. What is the difference?
Pure and impure.
One is carrying oxygenated blood, one is carrying inoxygenated. Simple? Any doubts till here? So let's repeat the whole thing so that it becomes cemented. How many parts of the brain?
Four.
What's the first part?
Brainstem.
Brainstem.
Second part?
Cerebellum.
Cerebellum. Third part?
Medulla.
Fourth part?
Cortex.
In the cortex, there are two parts of the brain present. Above the ear, left side?
Coronary
veins. Excellent. Right side?
Coronary
arteries. Coronary arteries and coronary veins are like the pipelines through which the water of Mumbai is going. Wherever there is a blockage in the Mumbai pipe, the plumber comes and fixes it, the cardiologist fixes, and generally wherever the blockage is there, they put a stent over there and they open it. Now this is human body. If you didn't put the stent, what will happen? Will you die? Question mark. First. Will you die?
May or may not.
Not possible, because there is meta-circulation will take.
Excellent. You will not die even if I didn't put a stent. Now people who have never heard of this are going to sit down and say, oh, how is that possible? You didn't do plumbing and what is she talking about? She's discouraging us from going to the plumber, the cardiologist. I'm not discouraging you through anything. This is human body. You suppress it, it will grow. You cut it, it will grow. You've seen a branch of tree? You cut. Does it stop growing?
No.
Your cutting the branch of tree is not going to stop something from growing. You cut a whole branch, it grows. Your liver can regenerate again, lizard can grow its tail back again, trees can grow its trunks back again. It may not grow in the same place, but it will grow in another place. These tubes which get grown in other places because you have blockages in your heart are called colectors. So first myth out, even if you have a blockage, are you going to die?
But colectors may not be for in all the cases.
Absolutely. But are you going to die?
How many percentage?
It depends. You get scared after you go to the doctor and doctor tells you you're going to die.
No.
Before that, you didn't even know that there was something going on, to be very honest. It is the fear of death that kills you faster than the actual problem. I'm not saying that problem will not be hindrance to your health, but it is the whole idea that I will die. Because before that, you didn't think you will die. But the day you were born, you were going to die someday or the other. And I've discussed this umpteen number of times. So we've covered up a little bit over here. How should we hear things? How should we be hearing things?
Without distortion.
Without distortion, excellent. So what do we generally do to what we hear? Can I rub up something or put down? Maybe I can put it down. What we generally do is, I'll use another pen.
We are allowing it to pass through a filter.
We are allowing it to either generalize, we distort by filling up the gaps.
Yes.
Or we distort information by eliminating it. We remove the information. We add information. That's filling up the gaps. Okay? So we're generalizing, we're distorting the situation, but we are never looking at the situation the way it is.
Yes.
We just don't process it. And why? Because we take in information to suit our beliefs and values. And then we say, "Hamare dil ko chot lagi." Kisi ne aapse kuch baat kari thi, but maybe they didn't even think it's going to hurt you. But you have, when I say here, you may have seen something which you feel you're still hearing it. So, maine aapko aise dekha, but I'm hearing, maybe you're just sitting like this, but I'm hearing that you're sitting cross-legged because you are cross with me.
Yes.
You getting it?
Yes.
And I might take his body language and say, okay, maybe he's bored with me. I might look at your body language and say, we are creating those talk even when we are seeing people. Now, what has that got to do with my heart? But your heart is pumping information. And your heart is taking that information from where? The first sense to take information is your heart. And it is हर दिल कुछ कहता है, हर घर कुछ कहता है, हर दांव कुछ कहता है, हर बात कुछ कहती है। आपकी ज़बान नहीं ज़रूरी कह रही है, पर आप जो प्रोसेस कर रहे हैं, जो आप देख रहे हैं, महसूस कर रहे हैं, उसको आप कन्वर्ट कर रहे हैं इनटू सुनना। और वो सुनना जो है आपका इंटरनल सुनना है। हमने शुरू से इंटरनली सुना है, which means when we were a little baby, we were hearing our mother's dub dub. Today, we may not hear our mother's dub dub, but we are hearing our nonsense. And 80% is nonsense. We repeat that 80% again and again and again. So I don't know कि ऐसी क्या चीज है जो आपको stress करके जाएगी, क्योंकि आपने हर information को generalize किया. Generalize means all men are like this. All Indians eat theplas. All Indians like spicy food. All Indians wear salwar kameez. All Indians are very neat and tidy. I love the generalization which came, because he was having an internet talk and said, no, it's not like this. So you getting my point?
Yes, a valid point.
A very valid point. So we have generalized the whole thing to suit our belief and our values. We have distorted a few things. How do we distort? Simple, huh? Now, graduation in my time meant that I came back home and showed my father I have passed. He tells me, you're a good girl, give me 500 bucks and says, go buy something for yourself. And I'm feeling very proud that I had 500 bucks to buy something. That was my graduation. My daughter's graduation, I went, my husband went, we spent tons of money, we reached there, we got our graduation gowns, dresses done, we got graduation dress done for her, and I spent quite a bit. 3 days, there was music, there was dances, there were parents meeting each other. At the end of 3 days, I was exhausted, and I looked at her and said, this is as good as your marriage. Only you don't have a boy. I mean, I got you married to your degree. Generalization in my head till then was, graduations are like how it was during my time. My father giving me 500 rupees, and I probably didn't even spend that 500 rupees. I put it in my lucky piggy bank and said, here I will earn more and put over here. That's what my dad's given me. Time has changed. I could have distorted that information and said, you children are spendthrift, again generalization, but distortion of information. But that is the generalization, that is the norm that is going on. So when we say generalization, we are talking about a norm. What is normal in a certain story? Have you understood that? Why am I giving you this background? Because you will not understand the conflicts of the heart till you understand how we process the information. If a girl is wearing clothes because it was very hot, very short clothes, yes, an Indian sitting there may look at her and say, so what if it's hot? At least she should cover herself up properly.
Yes. It's a natural reaction.
So what am I doing? I'm distorting the information. I'm removing a certain information and adding an unnecessary information over there. Or let's say if a girl and boy are very friendly with each other and are holding hands in public and maybe kissing lip to lip, I'm looking at them and saying, can't they go home and do it? लज्जा कुछ है कि नहीं, रिस्पेक्ट कुछ है कि नहीं, बड़ों की इज्जत करनी चाहिए. यू मीन टू से दैट हाउ इज दैट पर्सन डिसरिस्पेक्टिंग यू? दे डिडन्ट इवन हैव इट इन देयर हेड, बट यू हैव क्रिएटेड अ होल स्टोरी. एंड द लास्ट बिट इज व्हेन यू रिमूव इंफॉर्मेशन, लाइक इफ माय डॉटर कम्स इन माय हेड आई से ओ शी इज नेवर वर्न शॉर्ट क्लोथ्स, oh, she's never ever kissed anyone, I remove the information. Are you getting what I'm trying to say here? This is how we would look at information around the place. So you've understood this part? You've understood the year above that CVCA? When we are torn by what we hear, has someone heard you or have you heard yourself? Has someone told you that you're not beautiful, or have you told yourself?
Self-talk.
Has someone told you that you're dumb, or have you told yourself? Has someone told you that you are not economically okay, or have you spoken that to yourself? Has someone told you that you are looking, or you are not intelligent enough, or have you told yourself? What are you constantly hearing which is creating a hate, which is making you rate yourself because you are in a rat race? My dad said to me, I spoke about him last time, and said, dil se kaam karna. That made me think and I said, dil ka hi baat karta. Agar mujhe rat race mein rehna, if I have to follow people and be in the rat race, then I will rate myself how much can I conform to this rat race, and how much will I hate anything that is against the deviation, against the norm? And that hate means the anger that I hold in my heart. Why will I hold? What kind of anger can we hold in our heart? Think.
Grudges.
Very good. Like?
We don't like someone,
but we still are continuing to be with them because?
Circumstances.
Very good. Circumstances. What circumstances are making you stay in that situation?
Because it's maybe a relation or certain family.
Very good. It's always a relation and a
fear.
Family. Which creates the fear if you do not wear your family the way you are supposed to wear your family. We don't just dress ourselves with the clothes.
Yes.
We dress ourselves because we wear our families. We carry our families. And how do we carry our families? We speak like them. We talk like them. We think like them. We develop the norm that they have. We generalize the things that they generalize. We distort what they distort. We add what they add. We believe in the beliefs that they have, and our value system is solid rock.
And we proudly say this is our culture.
We say this is our culture and tradition. Are you getting it?
Not only that, we need to protect.
We need to protect it. So we do things to protect the wrong that we do. We don't question our family. No. Father said, go get married to that girl because she's pretty, she's white skinned, and of course she's of your gotra jat, and she eats the same food that you do, and she speaks the same language that we do, so that's enough credentials for you to get married tomorrow. Or your father says, I opened the business, I used to get 5 rupees from my father, I opened this whole business, I'm giving you a whole given business. What is your problem? That you want to go take a music system and go dun 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 and become bajewala. This is how we talk. Because we are coming from a limitation, and limitation of our search, our thinking. And why is all this important for your heart? Because all this information is first processed by your heart. Before it can even go to the brain, and brain can think which organ can it go to, now where I will put a conflict. All information that you know of, that I know of, is passing through your heart. Is this much clear?
There is a reason they say, no? I think it was Descartes who said, the heart knows the reason that reason cannot understand.
The heart knows the reason that reason cannot understand. Very good. And your heart will always tell you what is right. It's called the gut feeling. It's not just here. The gut feeling is your heart feeling. You know always, your heart knows always, your heart picks up information long before you can even think of it.
Yes.
A lot of research done by Hartmark Institute, huge amount of research that is done by them, shows that if we are happy, our actions are happy, and our heart is
healthy.
Yes. When we are carrying the burden of certain emotions because of our beliefs, our values, we are very, very sad. Have you all understood this before I go to the next part?
Yeah.
Clear? Absolutely. Any doubts here? Or you want me to recap anything?
Only one doubt, because there is a continuous communication between heart and
brain. That I will be talking about. In this part.
Absolutely.
Anything that is not clear?
Understood.
Understood. Okay, fine. So I'll wrap this up. Sure? You can go ahead. Remember, I've done a breakup of heart. What is the heart carrying? Look, I haven't gone, I made this slide, but they don't really look important. I will give you the slides also, I'll go through the slides also. Let's look at what's coming to my in my head. You remember we said CV? C?
Yeah.
You remember where was the CV? Coronary vein? Very good.
Carotid.
Yes. The CA, coronary
artery.
Is?
Right.
Very good. And right, where does it the center? Right above the?
Here.
Right above the?
Left.
Very good. So this is clear? So I'm making a? That's my era, by the way. Okay? In the brain. In the brain, in the part which is called the?
Cortex.
What is carried in it? Inside these veins?
Blood.
Now let's break up the blood. Blood is? What is a load that you have put on? And like when we say blood, khoon khoon ko pehchanta hai. Hindi movies. Tu mera khoon nahi hai, which means you don't belong to me, right? Khoon khoon ko pehchanta hai. Khoon pani se zyada gehra hota hai, whatever they call it. Which means we identify people by the blood. We identify not just by their blood groups, which are four. We have four blood groups. But we also identify people by saying, you belong to my bloodline.
Blood relation.
Yes. And this means that again, where I belong comes from my. In fact, when a genetic test is done, you see whether mother's group was what, father's group was what, and invariably if there is a rare group, you wonder where the child came from. Yeah. So literally, with the blood groups, you can actually know whether the child should be genetically
is yours.
Is yours.
But mutations are also possible.
Absolutely, everything is possible. So we are trying to search where we belong from our bloodline, which is carried in the heart, inside the CV and the CV. So my identity is present in the blood vessels. And this identity is not just created by your heart, no? Identity is created by your by the communication that's happening between your heart and the. Remember, your heart is listening and saying, this is correct, so I must do it. But that's your heart saying to you, this is correct, I must do it. But your identity is saying, which means your brain is sitting down and saying, but your papa told, don't have drug, not good. You will be a bad boy. Now there is a war between heart and the head. And you are carrying this little war inside your blood of your identity. So, a lot of issues which are connected with the blood are connected with our identity. I've just given you a breakup of what happens, what is carried in it. Now, what are the blood vessels made up of? Imagine this is blood, this and this portion, I've picked it up as two different, it's the same vein, it's the thickness of the vein. So if this was a glass and this was my vein, then I'm talking about this portion, and this portion is over here, and this portion is made up of the area which is belonging to two different parts of the brain. One part of the brain which it belongs to is called the medulla, the middle brain, which is connected, which is created. It is not made up of bones. Is it made up of bones?
No.
It's made up of muscle-like
soft
tissue. And that muscle-like soft tissue is present in the medulla. The blood is also present in the medulla. But what makes that blood vessel move that blood? Because it's not just moving by itself. How is it moving? It's not moving because somebody is picking it up and throwing it somewhere. It's moving because it is pressing. So there is peristalsis which is happening. So if I had a bottle, a plastic bottle, I could have crushed it and moved. That movement which is there is created in the part of the brain which is called the cortex. So I'll repeat it again. The blood vessel is made up of the area which is connected with. So which was the first part of the brain?
Stem.
Very good. Brain?
Stem.
Second part of the brain?
Cerebellum.
Third part of the brain?
Medulla.
Fourth part of the brain?
Cortex.
We already got in cortex, coronary artery, coronary vein. Now this part of the brain has got the blood vessel, is made up of the muscles which are present here. Simple? But the movement of this is present here. So they all one overlapping the other. So the substance with which it is made up over here. The movement is on the cortex. Is this part very, very clear? So, let's now understand what are the conflicts. Have you understood this? So, can I go to the next part?
Yeah.
Want to click a start? So, I think two, three things are there which are really important. With the blood will come the cholesterol. Mm. And I will explain to you mood swings over here. understand the conflict as to work on it. I'm not intending to do everything about the heart today. We'll break it into bite sizes, but understand the concept properly. Is that okay?
Yes.
Rather than doing everything, it will be too much for your brain to process. The distance between the head and the heart. So, dil kuch keh raha hai, dimag kuch keh raha hai. But dimag ke alag hisson mein alag parts hain brain ke. So, yes. So, yahan ek brain hai, jo aapka dil hai. But brain ke andar, different layers mein different part hai brain ke, heart ke. Coronary artery aur coronary vein aapke cortex mein hai, right on the top area. Movement of the heart, sari jo movement hai heart ki is dependent on the
cortex.
Jo muscles hai heart ki, the major portion of the heart is made up of muscles. Jo muscles hai heart ki, full jo heart hai aapka. So let's see how the heart actually looks. The full heart of yours, this whole thing, especially this portion, is made up of two kind of muscles. So imagine you take kapus, you take cotton and you take sponge. You have sponge and cotton to create the cushion of this chair. Imagine if this is the chair and I want to have a cushioning in this chair. That cushion of the chair is made up of two different kind of muscles, two different type of kapus. One cotton, which is normal cotton, and the other cotton, which is like a sponge. So one cotton is belonging to a different brain and the other cotton is belonging to a different brain. And then the movement of the brain is belonging to a different brain. I don't want it to get any more complicated. I just wanted you to know how complicated it can get.
Yes.
And if I really want to twist it, how complicated can it get? So let's keep it very simple. I just want you to understand that the major part of your heart is made of muscles which are present in it. And the major conflict of the medulla is, I am not good enough. Yes. So the major heart problems will be created because I am not
good enough.
Very good. That's all I wanted you to understand. Okay. So imagine if life was about these three pens. This is my mummy, papa saying this is correct, one pen. This my parents are saying, my school is saying this is correct, another pen. This is what I am saying is correct, three pens. And imagine your life is about balancing these three pens. So you are like a juggler. My school says, that's my education says this is correct. My parents say this is correct. I say this is correct. So if we got out of the story of what is right and what is wrong, what will happen? We will be not burdened. And it is overwhelming for us. It's too much for us to absorb. We are trying to be supermen and superwomen. Why? Kitab leke jaane wale ho aap yahan se, awards milne wale hain aapko. Ghar mein kisi ne aapko diya award? नहीं, हर घर में एक अवार्ड फंक्शन होना चाहिए, एटलीस्ट सालाना. लॉट ऑफ पीपल विल बी सेव्ड. जैसे बच्चा एक साल का होता है उसको एक अवार्ड मिलना चाहिए. बेटे आज तुम एक साल के हो गए हो. आई गिव यू एन अवार्ड दैट यू ग्रेजुएटेड वन ईयर. And you tolerated me for one year. When the child is old enough, he should stand and say, Mom and Dad, today I'm 4 years of age. I give you an award for being such great parents for me for these 4 years. And I will give myself an award because I tolerated this, this, this and that. And I will give you an award because you tolerated my temper tantrums. You tolerated all the tamasha that we gave you. What am I trying to say? We have no gratitude. We don't award. We never, we talk so much about gratitude. I'm telling you, apne sir ki jo bhi utar ke nahi dete kisi ko. We talk about that we are dharmatmas and paramatmas. We don't want to do anything free of charge. So what we are doing is, like I told you before, we are putting the burden of our dreams on our children, and our parents had put their dreams on us. So we all look like those gadhas who are carrying a lot of burden and walking like this. So we are overwhelmed. Imagine that chota sa nandha sa heart of yours, which is belonging to medulla, which is constantly doing dhup-dhup, and right from the time that the child was not even born, you are thinking, mera bachcha kala hoga, gora hoga, my beta hoga, beti hogi, sundar hoga, badsurat hoga. Will the child become Bill Gates? Will he be chaprasi? Intelligent hoga, murak hoga. We don't have any other similes in between. And it is too much for us and for our children to bear our nonsense. And this is what is creating heart attacks of the myocardium. Wonderful, right? Agar hum shayad itni complain karni band kar dein, shayad logon ko wo karne dein jo wo karna chahte hain. अगर हम वाकई अपने दिल को पंख दे दें तो शायद हमें इतना रिस्ट्रिक्ट होके जीना ना पड़े और शायद हमें इतनी सारी जगलिंग करनी ना पड़े. दिस जगलिंग इज क्रिएटिंग नथिंग एल्स बट कॉन्स्टेंट डब डब इन योर हेड. व्हाट डू आई डू, हाउ डू आई मैनिपुलेट पीपल सो दैट दे लाइक. एंड दैट इज द बिगेस्ट कॉज ऑफ हार्ट इश्यूज. Being overwhelmed, too much. It's too much for you to handle. So, aapko kaha gaya tha that when you became in 10th standard, you give your 10th standard exam, life will be jingala. You did that. We told you, le, you just completed 10th standard, you don't know 12th. You do your 12th, you'll become bada saab. You will earn a lot of money, you'll be fantastic. So you had something to look forward to. Now you studied, you educated yourself, and you gave your 12th standard exams. What happened after 12th standard?
Entrance.
Very good. After that they said, 4 years more, do graduation. When you do graduation, we'll call you a good girl and a good boy, because you would have really proved to us and to the whole world that we created an intelligent child. He's graduated. Now what? Now job. Excellent. Now next job. Now you do job and you will be, if you get so much dollars or so much yen or so much of euros or so much of Indian rupees, then you will be called successful. Then what?
Promotions.
Marriage. Then marriage, then children, then their story on the last day of your death. What are you saying?
Shukla ida.
Like Modi says, Achche din aayenge. Achche din aayenge. You are still waiting for Achche din aayenge. So we haven't really given ourselves any respite, and we continue the story, and as long as we continue the story, we will continue getting heart attacks. So what is the way that we can be successful without giving ourselves a heart problem? Is first decide what you want to do, and yeah, suno dusron ki, but apni bhi sun lo. Aap wo baatein sunte ho apne bare mein jo nahi sunni chahiye, और वो सुनते हो दूसरों की जो नहीं सुनी आप वो सुनो अपनी जो करना है आपने और वो अलग कर दो दूसरों की बातें जो आपने करनी ही नहीं है. Why create a conflict? We are not asking to disrespect anyone. We are asking you to respect yourself. दूसरों की जय से पहले खुद की जय. आप शायद भूल गए हो खुदा बाहर नहीं है आपके अंदर है और वो खुदा कहीं और नहीं आपके हार्ट के अंदर है और वो खुदा हर समय आपसे कुछ बोल रहा है और वो खुदा आपके अंदर ये कह रहा है खुश रहो. आपको मैंने सारा कुछ दिया है खुश रहने के लिए. इंसान इतना अनग्रेटफुल है. A human being, for whatever reason, hasn't learned to be happy at all. We are finding excuses why we should not be happy. We do not find excuses to be happy. Plentiful excuses we have why we, and then we deal with the situations because we want to get a bravery award. Believe me, the last award that is given to you is by your family. The award that they give you is that when you go away from this world, they remember you forever. Either with love or with sadness. If you were nice, if your interactions were loving, they want you and they miss you. If you were a person who constantly irritated other people, constantly made fun of other people, you were constantly having an attitude problem, then people, after you are gone, they say, thank God he is gone. So they get their space back from you, territorial. So let's now understand what are the conflicts here. So you've understood the conflict of myocardium, of these muscles. Also break down my o cardium. This is your car, is your actions. My actions. My actions, if are only about others and never about me, then what is going to happen? You will be a good girl who died of myocardium. Good girl or boy who died of a heart attack because your heart could not take your story anymore. You are trying to be a juggler who is juggling people. Mera mummy, mera papa, mera teacher, mera khuda, mera ye, mera wo, mera. But you haven't done anything.
Sabko khush rakhna.
Sabko khush rakhna. People pleaser. इजी लैंग्वेज में जितना समझा सकती थी बिल्कुल इजी करके समझाने की कोशिश करिए. नेक्स्ट कॉन्फ्लिक्ट है सीवी एंड सीए की. यहाँ तक करेंगे एंड देन वी डू लिटिल बिट ऑफ ये. इज दैट ओके? टू मेजर पॉइंट्स टू रिमेंबर फॉर द हार्ट इज दैट द हार्ट डिजीजेस शुड बी, यू कैन प्रिवेंट हार्ट डिजीजेस व्हेन यू नो दैट यू आर बीइंग अनहैप्पी अबाउट समथिंग. There is already a deterioration which has started in your heart. When you know you are not happy, please listen to your heart. When it is not happy, you will do the EFT that I will teach you today when you are not happy. Not when you are, not just after the heart attack. Aapko hosh aayi, you know, kisne aapko dhakka diya, uske baad to koi fayda nahi na. I'm trying to make you strong, be preventive. So I will give you a very big insight here and then we'll do EFT for both the things. Is that okay?
Yes.
And if you want, we'll continue with the heart next time.
Yes.
So that we
yes.
get more knowledge around the heart. So remember I said it is like this round. And these are the segments. Yeah. This segment. This one is on the left side and interestingly right at this center is also an addiction center. Right over here is also sexual centers. In the heart. So above the ear just want to remember this much.
Left side.
Above the ear, left side. You have sexual center. That means female cervix is present here. You also have an addiction center. And you have coronary bone. Very simply, I'm giving you this. If there are sexual conflicts, then the coronary vein gets impacted. I'll repeat again. Very interesting. Something that you never knew before.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's repeat again, okay? Left side, right here, coronary veins. And you have female part which is called the cervix. You can say with me. Coronary vein. Cervix. And addiction point. Simple part.
Yeah.
And these three areas are interconnected. So if I'm hitting on that area, one thing is getting impacted, the other thing is also getting clear? So the conflict of this area is that there is a rejection that has happened. And rejection is generally a sexual rejection or rejection of your identity. Remember I talked about blood, relation, bloodline, where you belong and your identity. Kisi ne aapko reject kar diya hai. Ladki ki shaadi hone wali thi, uski engagement toot gayi. The boy was to get married, everything happened, they got married in front of the whole world and the girl ran away on that night. This is sexual rejection. In our country, it's a wholesale sexual rejection in front of everybody. Izzat ka faluda hona. Anything to do with izzat ka faluda hona, which means someone has thrown crap and shit at you and your identity has got impacted.
Loss of identity.
Yes. Or someone has looked at you and said, kya teri shaadi hogi, tu to moti hai. Loss of your identity and a very sexual remark.
Yes.
But we don't even realize. We speak like this every day to our children. This causes a conflict which can then impact the coronary vein and cause a blockage in the vein other than the cholesterol, other than the fatty food that you are eating. The nonsense information that you are carrying inside your system, which is going to then circulate from your heart into your coronary vein, will carry this information and will also create a hormonal imbalance. So a girl might start growing hair around her chin. A man might start feeling more nurturing. He might become more overprotective, nurturing or depressive. It is all dependent on our wiring. What is the wiring? Let's look cover our wiring. This is our hand. So put it down here like this. And if you were watching a movie, and the movie was very nice, and in that movie Shah Rukh Khan came and he said, I'm the best, I'm the best. How could you clap? Clap! Come on. I don't want you to clap like a penguin. I want you to clap. Which is the stronger hand with which you're clapping? Even if you did this, you will still be clapping with that hand only. That is your wiring. Okay?
Right.
Very good. So either you will be having more dominating right hand or more dominating left. Can you imagine this causes mood swings? All the sexual remarks that people are making today, including sexual abuse, including, and for in our country there are plenty the girl turns 10 and 9 and 8 and her life is finished. Right from her periods to whether what kind of clothes she will wear, who she will play with, to a boy as he is growing older.
And at that age suddenly restriction comes.
And because the restriction is there, she is going to have mood swings. She is going to start having huge issues. And very important, within our marriages, there is nothing even today that is recognized as sexual abuse. Within marriage, there is nothing called rape, I believe. There is nothing, yes. And I don't even know how many girls really know what is the meaning of sex. And she is told all her life that she has to cover herself up, right from Krishna being shown in the thing with just tying a thread here, and he has no underpants, to a girl always being covered, to when we are explaining about a girl or a boy, we say this is eyes, this is nose, this is lips. We never say this is vagina, that is penis. We never say that. Why? Why do we use funny names like
taboo? Is that right?
Why? But your taboo is creating depression and manic problems, which is starting very early in age, because the centers of addictions are right there. We are pushing people into a lot of addiction because addiction centers are right. This is just an information. We can grab it and maybe we can change something about our next generation to come by not being so rigid. सोच रिजिड हो गई तो आप रिजिड हो गए. अगर आप बहते रहे तो रिजिडनेस खत्म, और अगर रिजिडनेस खत्म आपकी लाइफ बिल्कुल ठीक था. एंड इमेजिन कीजिए अगर आपके हार्ट की मसल्स रिजिड हो जाए, आपकी कॉर्नरी वेन्स रिजिड हो जाए, तो आप उनको क्या बोलेंगे? इज दैट व्हाट यू वांट? यू आर ट्राइंग टू रिमूव रिजिडिटी. And here the rigidity is getting created. So when women feel not pretty in their marriages, when they feel rejected by their spouse, it's not just marriage, today with the new culture, which is, hookup culture. There's nothing wrong with any of the things. I'm just giving you what can happen, the probabilities. Initially it was one marriage, one man, rejections, mother-in-law scenario, father-in-law scenario. Today there is a rejection that happens over a phone, over a WhatsApp. I know of marriages which are called off over a WhatsApp. There is no explanation, there is no closures which are given to people. And people have become as obsolete, as worse than your discarding your shirts. It's like disposable tissue that you have in the bathroom, which you use, you wipe your ass and then you throw it off. And that is how today the relationships have become. You literally use, you wipe yourself and then you dispose it off. Honey, but you were so pretty, and honey, you were so good. And hey, that's a great experience to have, but it's doing something to your body. And that part is also connected with your heart. Dil dukta hai, dil mein dard hoti hai. Let's go back to the first line that I said, Bollywood stories, Bollywood songs, but nobody talks about how many tears went behind creating that mehuna. In real life, when you want the man to stand for you and you say, aap ho kya? He's really nobody. You find yourself all alone. And all those then you realize are just the dreams, but not the reality. And then you say, when you come to know about the reality, and then that hurts. I hope this is very, very clear. This part I will explain and then we go to the EFT. Is that okay? How much time do we have? Perfect. So coronary arteries is all about territory. Aap apni jagah ke shahanshah hai, raja hai. Ghar mein har insaan apna raja hota hai. So, to talk about territory, what does a territory mean? What does it mean jab main aapko bolun ki, all the issues over here are connected with territorial. Like all issues over here are generally to do with your identity, generally to do with sexual issues, generally to do with rejections around sexual issues. And when sexual issues, it doesn't mean you're having sex. It can be like somebody looking at you and saying, Moti hai, tingi hai, choti hai, choto, moto, all these words. And we continue to do it all the time. I'm guilty of doing it, you're guilty of doing it, all of us have been doing it.
Knowingly or
unknowingly?
We don't think it has an impact on our body.
Yes.
We think only virus, bacteria, and in heart matters, we don't even talk about virus, bacteria. We talk about cholesterol, exercise, lethargy, and I give you the other things that. We use these as the whole story. We say smoking, high cholesterol, high blood pressure, it didn't like staying there. Diabetes, being inactive, unhealthy diet, isolation, depression are cause of our problem. But that isolation just didn't happen by itself, no?
Yeah.
And being inactive just didn't happen by itself. Your high blood pressure just didn't happen by itself. Something is going on there. Your body did something to reach there also. Remember, aap sab ek kahani ho. Main ek kahani ho.
Yes.
Aap ek kahani ho. Hamari kahani badal gayi, to hamari body ke saath rishta badal gaya. Humne apni kahani ko change kar diya, humne apni bimari ko change kar diya. Our disease is nothing but a story that has not got completion. The story has to get completion within a certain time. Wo story agar aapne 9 mahine se zyada drag kari hai, if you have pulled a story for more than 9 months, then sorry, it can be fatal. Isliye bahut zaruri hai ki you deal with your stress as fast as possible, usse drag mat kare. Agar aap, if you are carrying your stress for more than 9 months, it's like a full-born baby. You will not deliver a baby, but you will deliver a disease. Have you got it? I think that's made it very clear. More than 9 months, you carry your stress, you will not deliver a baby, but you will deliver a disease, even if you sort out your stress. If you want the stress to be sorted out, abort it before it becomes a baby. Which means right in the first 6 weeks of you conceiving your stress, you must do everything to deal with that stress. If it is of any of the sexual kind, anything to do with rejection, anything to do with not feeling, remember for the muscles I said feeling overwhelmed, anything. Jab you are starting to be unhappy, sit down and work with it. Not when it is done. Tab to kahani khatam ho jayegi. Raja Rani ek tha, Raja ek thi Rani, dono mar gaye, khatam kahani. Right? Ek tha stress, ek the aap. Dono ne ek dusre ko kha liya, khatam kahani. To will you let your stress eat you, or will you eat your stress and convert it into desserts? That's more important. So let's go here. Coronary artery, I said territorial. Territorial means aap sab bakri hain. Main, jo mera, mera beta, mera ghar, my house, my property, my child, aur kya kya kehte hain, my car, my servant, my pillow, my chair, my chashma, my clothes, bura na sir ki jo bhi utha ke dete, my jew, my shampoo, my toy to begin with, my mummy, my papa. They say sharing is caring, but I don't care and I don't like to share. So if you can't share, and you will have to share what is yours. So your first territorial story start when your little baby boy or a baby brother or a baby sister come into your story. That is territory. Meri zindagi mein koi to aaya hai. Jo har cheez jo meri hai wo leke ja raha. Because before that wo sirf aapka. After some time wo sirf aapka nahi raha. Simple example. You were walking around with this man, you'd fallen in love with him and you really, really wanted to get married to him. So you were holding his hand and you were both walking around and it was such a pleasant sight. He looked at you and you looked at him and you said, my God, the world is full of stars and nothing else matters but you and I. And then came the marriage and then came his mother. And then came his father. And slowly, even though you were in his house, every day morning when you would get up, you would hear your mother-in-law saying, whatever his name is, let's assume his name is Danny. Danny! And you would suddenly say, so, not mine. He doesn't belong to me the way I thought he should belong to me. I'm sure you understand what I mean.
Yes, yes.
That's what is there. You want to keep everything that is yours. Aapki 5 rupaye bhi gum jaate hain, aap kaise dhoondte usko? Aise jab aapki dost gum jaate hain, it can be a death of a person, it can be someone taking away, it can be migration in India, Pakistan. Migration when World War II happened, how many people died? I mean, I saw so many Vietnamese soldiers who died. I saw the crematorium the other day. So much of destruction, so many people, my land. Sometimes nothing that you call your own remains your own.
Yes.
Nothing. All the things that you want to hold like this in your heart, none of them remain yours. And that is what we call the territorial chaos. Aapki biwi sirf aapki thi, par kya hua na, aap neighbor ghar pe aap baar baar bula rahe the, usko baar baar chai bula rahe the, biwi ko bol rahe the, bahut acha neighbor hai, aapki help karega. To aapne us time shortcut dhoonda kyunki aapko book padhni thi. और आपका नेबर आपकी बीवी के साथ बैठ के चाय पी रहा था. थोड़ी देर के बाद पता लगा आपकी बीवी और आपका नेबर चाय पीते पीते बहुत दूर निकल गए और आप भूख के लास्ट बनने पे पहुंच के
कब फिसल गए पता नहीं चला.
भूख का लास्ट पन्ना पढ़ के बोल रहे आई लॉस्ट माय वाइफ बट आई फिनिश्ड द बुक बट आई लॉस्ट माय दैट इज टेरिटरी. I think it's very well understood what
yes.
is that story, right?
Yes.
So let's do a little bit of tapping because for tapping we will start with I'm feeling overwhelmed, it's too much, too overworked. So first we'll work only for the myocardium today. But before that, let's just do tapping and see whether our breathing becomes better. Why is the breathing important? Because oxygen has to come. What's the function of the heart? To make
pure.
What we'll do next time is, we'll bring some sound in for your heart, we'll bring some more information in for your heart, and I will play around for you guys so that the heart really calms down and you can then understand how the heart is really reacting with it. And we'll do some more fun activities and some more stuff. So we won't end the heart here, we'll do another part of it. Is that okay?
Yes, yes.
Yeah? Will that work?
Sure.
Okay. So let's first just bring in more oxygen for our heart. Let's just start tapping points right here.
It's any side?
Any side, it doesn't matter. You can do this, you can do this, you can do this. So even though life is all about chaos, I can
allow myself
to have fun in this chaos.
Have fun in this chaos.
No? A child doesn't think it's chaos, no?
Yes.
How does the child play in the room? You give him full of room, full of rati also. He will sit down and make some game out of it. But we make life, which is very orderly, into rati. So we don't know how to make fun in our life. I just want you to judge how much is your breathing to begin with. On the scale of 0 to 10, right now I feel my breathing is around 6. 6 is the ease with which I'm breathing. It doesn't feel like more than that. Can you all breathe and see how much is yours?
6.
How much would yours be? 6. How much would yours be?
6.
6-7. Even though my breathing is?
My breathing is.
Like 6.
Like 6.
In this chaos. I can allow myself to have fun.
To have fun.
And increase my breathing. Top of the head. Very lightly here. Please remember, it has to be very soft, like butterfly kiss. Carl Dawson, who's taught me, always talks about butterfly kiss. And I love that expression. Very delicate. Yeah? Shabash. I can give myself permission. To breathe better. To have more fun in life. Life is always going to be chaos. I can allow myself
to have more fun
and give myself permission to breathe better. Now, in between these eyebrows, you have over here both the parts of the eyebrows, but I can tap in between all this point like this.
Very good.
Again, delicate, like butterfly kiss. I can allow myself to breathe better.
I can give myself permission to have fun.
Side of the eyes. You give myself. All these points that we are tapping on are our different organs in the body. Okay? I can allow myself to breathe better.
Heart doesn't breathe, it's like the lungs that breathe.
But heart is sitting right in between your lungs. And the blood goes into the lungs to purify it. Okay, so it's very connected. I can give myself permission to have fun. This point right down is very good for the stomach problems. Very good for acidity. This right here. Ye wala point. Very good. Very delicately. Sarji yaha. Ye wala point, please. Here. This bone. Hospital bone over here. This point. Very good. I can give myself permission to breathe better. So you can have that affirmation going on each point at least 3 times. Okay? Under the nose, very delicately again. I can give myself permission to breathe better. I can give myself permission to have more fun. Life is any day of chaos. Chin area, here, right here, this part. In that depression over here. Okay, very good. I can give myself permission to breathe better. Tapping helps with everything, not just heart, okay? I can give myself permission to breathe better. You have this bone. You see this bone?
Yeah.
Yeah. You can feel the bone down after that. This portion on the flat bone is very. I can give myself permission
to breathe.